It used to be that you could only warn one person about a tornado after it had already blown down someone else's barn.
Now, on average, we're able to issue a tornado warning 15 minutes before the tornado's even there, and that wouldn't be happening without Doppler radar.
This NEXRAD system has reduced fatalities on the order of 45% due to tornadoes since its advent.
We have a lot more information now about storms and being able to understand how they develop, how they produce severe weather, and how that information might be used to improve warnings for our National Weather Service partners.
The lab is unique in that we serve the nation by supporting the National Weather Service in its mission to protect lives and save property by improving the accuracy and the lead time of severe weather warnings.
We have a legacy of radar research and converting existing technology from military to weather purposes.
A recycled Doppler radar led to the development of NEXRAD, installed nationwide in the early 90s. It allowed forecasters to see storms like never before.
Not only did we help bring that technology to the National Weather Service and to help protect lives and property, but we have continued to upgrade that technology, keep it relevant, and keep it state of the art.
Recently, a major upgrade was added. Dual polarization technology takes the radar from 2D to 3D. Forecasters now know more about what type of precipitation is falling, which is very helpful during winter storms, as well as how much rain is accumulating, resulting in better flash flood warnings. The radar can also detect and track tornadoes based on debris. Looking to the future, the National Severe Storms Lab is testing the capabilities of phased array radar. Originally used by the U.S. Navy, the antenna scans the skies electronically rather than mechanically, allowing the radar to focus on a storm.
With current technology, we get a full picture or image of what is going on within a storm every 4 to 5 minutes. So it's more like a snapshot. Whereas with phased array radar, we get that picture of what's going on in the storm every minute. So it becomes more like watching a movie. So we can do adaptive, rapid scanning on the storms that matter most, being able to provide the information that's most relevant when and where it's happening.
Another advantage of phased array radar is its multifunction capability, providing weather and air traffic information simultaneously.
Number one, it is a system that promises to replace and expand upon the existing weather surveillance radars. Secondly, to replace aging air traffic surveillance radars. And number three, it offers a potential application to meet Department of Homeland Security and defense requirements for identifying and tracking non-cooperative aircraft. With the replacement of all these various radars with a single system, the American taxpayer could realize substantial savings in cost.
You have a lot fewer radars to maintain, and the electronic capability of this also reduces maintenance costs because you do not have moving parts.
Not too long ago, the ability to predict severe weather was thought to be impossible. During the past several decades, research conducted at the National Severe Storms Lab has developed life-saving tools like Doppler radar. We've progressed from no warning of threatening weather to about a 15-minute lead time, and current research promises to extend that much further.
Our knowledge of severe storms and how they behave, and our use and ability to use the Doppler radar technology, and is in a lot of cases a direct result of that close working relationship, that research to operations component that we get between the National Severe Storms Laboratory and a forecast office.
That history and understanding of how these data can be used by our users and doing the research to help advance the use of radar technology, really it's what we live for. It's in our lifeblood, it's in our history.